Good afternoon, students. So we will continue with our topic, and the topic was sanitation. Topic was sanitation. So sanitation means mostly to sanitize it or to clean it, okay, or to make it hygienic, okay, mostly. So in our previous class we talked about what is the importance of sanitations and what was the disease related to what, okay. Then it's different types of diseases, as we talked about waterborne diseases also. So today we will be talk about sewage system, that means alternate alternative arrangement of sewage disposal. Alternative arrangement of sewage disposal. Okay, so we mostly talked about sewage. So sewage is actually the liquid waste, okay. Sewage is actually a liquid waste, which includes organic, inorganic and microorganic waste. And mostly we talked about yesterday in organic waste, we talked about mostly human faces. Human faces means the stool or the waste product that we remove from our body. Okay, so in our previous classes we talked about it's a wastewater treatment plant. Wastewater treatment plant. So it is a plant to purify water or to make water usable. Water usable, not in terms of drinking, but in terms of other uses, as for example to use in industries, to use in agricultural field, or to use for bathing and wash. Okay, but this is a high cost. This is of high cost, that means it requires huge amount of money, which even a normal person can't bear it. Okay, so in big cities human excreta is carried, some human faces or human excreta. Okay, so this was only to explain you, you can erase this. So in big cities human excreta means the toilet, okay, the toilet to which most of the people they use it. So human excreta is carried through sewage pipelines. So it is carried through sewage pipeline. That means some pipelines are there, okay, through our toilets to certain places. As for example, I talked about the drainage system or the wash basins. Similar in the case of, suppose this is a house, okay, this is a house, here we have house, we are here house. So each house have toilets, okay, that means to remove the excretory products from our body, and each have a pipeline. It's not that we simply throw the waste product in an open area, it's not hygienic, okay. It can spread the diseases and cause much more harm. So each and every household have a toilet and each have a sewage pipeline, and this pipeline, suppose this is a pipeline. And this pipeline, what happens to this pipeline? A bigger sewage it get mixed with the bigger pipe and it's removed in an open area. That means this is a sewage pipeline. Okay, so sewage pipeline, sewage treatment plant, this is called sewage treatment plant or sewage pipeline. So lying sewage system is a high cost, that means it requires much more amount. So it's not that easy to build by your own. Okay, so to make an alternative, alternative means effective, effective and of low cost, that means which you can afford, affordable. Okay, effective or affordable, that means a good number of smaller towns and most of the rural areas do have sewage system. That means this sewage system we find in cities, okay, towns, and in village, as you all know, there is no sewage system at all. Either people in previously, either people used to go in open fields or in river banks, but nowadays due to Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, okay, due to Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, the government of India have formulated a proposed that each and every household should have a toilet. That means should they should not open, they should not use open field for defecations, okay, as a toilet. So to improve sanitation, low cost on-site sewage disposal system are being installed. That means low cost online, sorry, on-site, that means low cost on-site sewage disposal, on-site sewage disposal system is carried out, you can write carried out. Okay, on-site means not using the sewage pipeline, okay, because what it requires, it requires pipes, it requires the land should be dug, then waste should be removed at certain places. That means it is of high cost. So low cost on-site disposal system means at the same place. Suppose this is a house, okay, suppose this is a house, and suppose there is a toilet here, okay, that means as we all know, our waste products, they disintegrates, that means they dried up, okay, and act as a manure. So a pit is dug, pit means ghadda, okay, and whatever the waste products, they get into the, they are stored in the, what you can say, soil, at that place only, okay, at that place only, and that is called the use of septic tank, use of septic tank. Okay, so it is a very effective method. That means the septic tank can be made very nearer to the home. Okay, after digging it and applying some concrete and making as a well, kuwe ki tarah banana, okay, making as a well, septic tanks, chemical toilets and compost pits. So three things are there. Number one, septic tank, chemical toilets, and third one is composting pits. So we have basically these three types. Number one, number 2 and number 3 as an alternative arrangement of sewage disposal, as an alternative arrangement of sewage disposal. Okay, construction of septic tank, construction of chemical toilets and composting pits. So septic tanks, I have already explained that a tank is made, okay, near the toilet. A tank is made at a far places or even below the house, it can be made. Okay, where a dig is, well like structure is made, and all the excreta, okay, or human waste, they goes in the ground, and soil absorb all the things, liquid, and at that place only it is dried up. Number one. Number two, chemical toilets, it can also be used, okay, and it is mostly used in aeroplanes and trains, okay, in railways, aeroplanes, et cetera, and other related vehicles. Okay, so previously what used to happen in railways, okay, in trains, mostly the human excreta is thrown in the railway track, but nowadays due to chemical toilets, these all get decomposed. Due to the chemical process, the human excreta is decomposed at the same place, okay, resulting in the a good hygiene practice. Then we have composting pits. Composting pit means making a gadda, okay, same as in case of septic tank. So septic tanks are suitable where there is no sewerage system. If there is no sewerage system, we can use septic tank, okay. For hospitals, isolated buildings, or a cluster of 4 to 5 houses, septic tanks need cleaning every 4 to 6 months. That means in septic tank there is a well-like structure. Okay, there is a well-like structure. Well-like structure means kuwe ki tarah hota hai. Aur jab ye, when it is filled, slowly when it is filled, after a certain period of time, say for example 5 to 6 months, it must be cleaned. Why it must be cleaned? Because if it is overflowed, what will happen? It can come in the open area or in the surface of the earth, okay, or near you. So that also can causes much more harm, okay, in terms of sanitation and diseases. Okay, so it must be cleaned every 5 to 6 months. So the toilets based on the use of human waste for producing biogas are being also encouraged. That means the human excreta, okay, the human excreta is also utilized for biogas. Okay, and for biogas, what happens in biogas? It is mostly used for act as a cooking or fuel, because our excreta contains methane. Our excreta contains methane, and which is a good fuel. Okay, so this can also be used, okay, not for cooking but for other purposes it can be used. The excreta from the toilet is sent to the biogas plant through pipes, converted drains. Biogas so produced is used as a feed. Okay, that means it can be used. That means our waste product can be utilized if it can be done in a correct method. So this was all about alternative arrangement of sewage disposal. Now let's talk about sanitation at public place. So this was not for public place, this was regarding your neighborhood or regarding your houses. So what about in public places? Okay. So as we have discussed in our earlier classes, that better housekeeping practices must be done. Better housekeeping practices must be done. As for example, it's not that you clean your house and make your surrounding dirty. Okay, it's not that. So sanitation at public places. What do you mean by public places? Public places are places which are common to all. As for example, hospitals, you can say stations, okay, railway stations, or you can say bus stands, religious places, etc. So these all are public places. So railway station, bus stand, hospitals are so all, and even you can include market also. These all are public places. So it's not that we should not keep these places clean. It's not our responsibilities. No, it's our responsibilities to keep it clean. Okay, like these places are mostly crowded. So large amount of garbage waste is generated in public places. So if you go to railway station or if you get to bus stand, what will happen? You will see many people, even in hospitals also, even in market also. You will see many people go there for some kind of walk. And obviously, there is a, we throw waste everywhere. Okay, that means this place, near these places, the dirt or the garbage, the garbage is much more in number. Okay, because everyone throw garbage there. Okay. The local government or the municipalities, okay, they have organized some, they have done some work regarding this, like putting up the dustbin, okay, putting a dustbin in that area. But instead of this also, most people are very much careless. They don't go and throw the garbage in the dustbin. No, they will not go. They will just throw in the road. Okay, in local, in same place where they are standing. So what happens in that terms, in this case, waste is not dispersed properly, it can give rise to epidemic. Epidemic means, right now we are facing the epidemic. Okay, epidemic means the causes of disease. That means spread of diseases. Spread of diseases. That means spread of disease in huge amount. Okay, that means more people are affected. Epidemic means spread of disease in a large number. So for that, we should follow certain sanitation process in these places. So what we should do, or what we can do? Number one, what we can do? So number one, we should not spit or urinate in open. Spit or urinate in open. That means as in the case of nowadays, okay, nowadays due to the virus COVID-19, we are very much careful. Okay, we don't spit, okay, or we use mask. So that means it can be said that through mouth also various types of diseases can be spread. and that is regarded as communicable diseases. Okay, same. So if you spit in open, if you spit in open, that means we don't know that by which virus or by which bacteria we have been affected, and the spread can, and the sorry disease can be spread. Okay, even urination. Okay, urinate in open. Okay, it's our responsibility to not do this. We should find a perfect place where there is a arrangement for urinating and go there and do. Number second, use dustbin for throwing garbage. Use dustbin for throwing wastes. Okay, it's not that you just eat something, eat chips or eat biscuits and throw that wrap, okay, or the plastics in the road. Okay, you should be very much careful and what you can say, you should throw that in the dustbin nearby. Okay, dustbin nearby. Number three, not throwing plastic package material or shopping bags on the road. That means same. Throwing waste means it includes same. It includes same. All wastes. All type of all wastes. Types of garbage. All types of garbage. It can be organic, it can be inorganic. Okay. Organic means mostly related to living things, jaise the peel of bananas or fruits, okay, apples, and inorganic mostly plastics are there. Okay, we should not throw these all things. And then last one, educate your family, neighbors and friends about the need of sanitation at places. That means spreading awareness. Spreading awareness regarding sanitation and cleanliness. Okay, that means we should spread awareness regarding sanitation. Okay, as we have as we are doing in terms of COVID-19. Okay, we are not we. It should be government also. Government also are focusing on the same thing. Okay, that's why in when phone rings or in public places, big hoardings are placed. What to do, what not to do. Okay, and it's not that only government responsibility is there to do the same. It's our responsibility also to spread awareness. That means if you go to market and if someone is throwing the garbage in the road, you can tell him or you can complain to the authority for that. For this person or in this area, certain garbage is being thrown. Okay, and that will be looked after by the the local government, okay, or the municipalities. Okay, so the thing is that we should spread awareness in terms of sanitation. So this was all about sanitation at public places.